Hey, what's going on, guys? Kurosama here. Now, today we're taking a look at a Transformer review, and honestly, I just wasn't up to doing any more Transformer reviews since my last few ones, which I think was the MPM Megatron. That was like the last one, and Cliffjumper. I just kind of didn't really feel it. But a couple of people in the Discord said that they would love to see me do the review for RC, and you know what? I think I would too. Not too many people on like Facebook and Reddit has been giving it positive attention. So I think I can be a person who's going to look at it with unbiased eyes and say this is either a good figure or it's a bad figure. So we'll go ahead and check it out in the review. So we'll take a look at the box. Honestly, the front cover art looks great. It has a really good pose. You see the alt mode right there. It is number 51 in the Masterpiece line. And then if you just go over to the side, you have RC in a very seductive pose. And to be honest, out of all the times I've watched Transformers and I've seen her, whether it's in the show or it's in the movie, I don't remember poses like this. So I think Japan pretty much knows the audience. So on the backside, you get to see the alt mode, you see some effect parts, you see some poses, and her with the squad all together. So, looks really good, but it's just a box. Let's go ahead and check out what's on the inside. Now straight out of the box, we're just going to have the alt mode. So I'm going to review this first, and then we'll get into the robot mode. But the alt mode looks fine. I love the color pink that it has. It's very bright. It looks good. The white looks great. And it has a very glossy sheen to it. And if you look on the inside where the dash is, you do see some like details as well as some color application right inside there. Overall, I think it looks great. You have a little bit of that gray. I love the gray. Honestly, it kind of breaks up the pink and the white. Looking really good. You have the clear blue visor for the windshield, I should say. It's fine. It's a Cybertronian race car or kind of like sports car. It does its job. And I think just if you're looking at everywhere except underneath, you're going to see a really good alt mode. So I hope no one goes online and they just complain because if you look underneath, you see like pretty much all of her stuff and all the legs and arms and hands. Like it's just that's Transformers for you, okay? This isn't Macross we're talking about here. The robot's usually first, alt mode second. Now for accessories on the alt mode, you are gonna have like this tire slasher on the side. It's okay. It's just a tire slasher. I'm never going to use this. It's probably just going to go back in the packaging, and that's really just it. So, it looks good. Paint application on this is fine. It has, like, some silver on the tip, and that's really all I can say about it. Now, for size comparisons, here it is next to my four-wheel drive and my 172 Macross VF25. So I went ahead and transformed her off screen, and honestly, she was pretty easy to transform. The instructions were very simple, and I didn't have much of a tough time actually transforming her. Now talking details, she looks really good. I honestly have like no issues on the front side looking at her, but when you look at the back side, that's when you're going to have most of your issues, especially like on the side, because the backpack itself is very large and it's not as accurate to the actual cartoon animation, which at this point I'm kind of used to, especially with like building model kits. There's a lot of liberties that are taken to make something into a figure or into a model form, so it honestly doesn't bother me. To some people who want like true, you know, cartoon accuracy on their shelf, I understand. But with someone like me, I can still really enjoy her overall, and you'll see why in later part of this review. Now, another gripe I do have is going to be the chest. It's a lot more pointy and just blocky looking than what I remember in the cartoon. It's really different. I don't know why they went with this choice instead of just making it a little bit more smooth. But I don't know, man. This is Japan that we're talking about. They probably like said, hey, we want some bigger, pointier metal breastplates. So for articulation, she's not too bad, but there are some issues. The best thing about the articulation on this figure is going to be in the arms. These arms can move all over the place, and it's definitely going to allow her to do more dynamic poses. My major issues with the articulation is probably going to be in the legs, because the legs cannot move back that far because her ass is huge and it is just not allowing her to move back that far at all. And to the sides, her hips are really just wide and thick, so she's not being able to do like splits or anything crazy like that. The best thing you can do is, you know, move the legs a little bit forward. So you're going to have to work with that and do some good aerial poses. Now the feet, this is probably my biggest complaint, because if anything, the thing you need to do when it comes to figures or model kits is have good ankle pivot. And this figure has no ankle pivot whatsoever. It can move back and forth. That's fine, especially when it comes to kneeling poses. But man, I just want a side-to-side bend, and she doesn't do that. Now for accessories, we're going to just go right into the head. Now the head is going to have a gimmick to where you can open it up, flip out a visor, and then you just slide the headpiece one stage back within the head, and flip it down, bam, now she has like a little visor. The faces that she's going to come with though is kind of like a smiling face, an open mouth face, a kind of concerned looking face, and a pretty neutral face. Now going into the weapons, she is going to have a handgun. Looks really good. I don't really have any issues with it in the hand. It can also be stored in the backpack, which is really convenient. And it's also going to have this effect part, so whenever you're putting it in dynamic poses, it's going to look that much better on your shelf. Next is going to be a larger hand pistol. So this one, it's just all pink. It kind of doesn't look that great in comparison to the handgun. But what's cool with this one is that it actually is going to come with a holster. So you can just strap that to the side of the leg and plug it right in. This too is going to have an effect part. So go ahead, plug it right in. And it's going to look really good doing any kind of poses. And lastly, she is going to come with a rifle, and this is actually my favorite weapon of hers. It looks really good, I love the details on it, and it can store right there on the side of the backpack. And lastly, it's going to come with an effect part, and I love it because it just makes the overall weapon look that much bigger, and doing some good aerial poses is probably what I'm going to go to whenever I'm putting it on the shelf. It's also going to come with an instruction booklet and a card. Now for comparisons, here she is next to MP Hot Rod and MP10 Optimus Prime. So what are my final thoughts? Honestly, I really do like this figure. I mentioned it in my initial thoughts, and the transformation is simple. The overall paint application is really good, and she is super glossy. So I think whenever you have her with a lot of lights hitting her, it's going to look really cool and kind of like 80s retro style if you have different color lights hitting on her. So I don't know, man. I'm really into it. I don't think it's worth the price tag though, because she comes in at around $120, give or take. So that's really steep. And that's kind of going into my overall verdict. I want to say cop it, but I can't justify it with the backpack issue, the lack of articulation in certain areas, and the price tag. It's not a drop it, because she's actually pretty cool. So I'm gonna give it a watch it. And what you're watching out for is essentially that price tag. If you can get that price tag probably below $80, I think that's actually a really good range for the figure that you're gonna get. Maybe if you wanna go a little bit lower because the backpack really bothers you and it just doesn't like, you know, match with the rest of your figures that are like super anime accurate or whatever, that's fine. But I'm going to deem it a watch it if you can get it probably below about $80. It's probably going to be on sale at Target at some point, probably relatively cheap. I probably should have also waited, but I'm very impatient and I've pre-ordered her because I just really wanted her in my collection. I'm a pretty big G1 buff when it comes to the core cast. And although she wasn't a part of the original G1, you know, series, she was a part of the movie and then the next seasons thereafter. And I really enjoyed the movie. It's probably one of my favorite cartoon movies to date. And I thought she was really cool. She's not the most standout character, but she stands out to me because she is the first female bot. So I'm really enjoying her. I think she looks really cool. And if you guys do enjoy, you know, this particular type of figure, hey, go ahead and get her. But that's all from me. Please go ahead and subscribe if you have not already and you do enjoy these videos. If you did enjoy this particular video, go ahead and leave a like and ring that bell for future notifications of reviews and other types of videos. But that's all from me, guys. I will be seeing you in the next video. Bye-bye.